Hey, Robin here from Post Professionals. Here, just one chapter from one of my longer videos for easier access. But if you prefer to watch the whole thing in one go, you can find the link either up here or down in the description. Either way, I hope you enjoy, and if you do and it was helpful, maybe do me a solid and give me a thumbs up, or even smash the old subscription button, which really helps the channel. Thanks, and now this. Sticking with the subject of aspect ratios, what if, for example, you haven't yet conformed your regular project to square and would just like to get a good idea of what things may look like after you conform and what the possible constraints will be space-wise? Well, that's where the all-new overlays come in. Clicking on the Viewer's View menu shows us that in the Overlays section, next to the previously existing Title and Action Safe as well as Horizon overlays, we now have two new custom overlay menu items. Normally, selecting the first Show Custom Overlay menu point, you're able to turn any custom overlay you may have selected on and off. But right now, I can't, since I haven't actually yet chosen one to display. That is done with the second new menu item. Here in its submenu, we see the option to add a custom overlay. Selecting it opens a dialog box with which I can navigate to whatever image overlay I would like to use. I've actually put together a small collection of various overlays that I personally find very useful. On the one hand, various aspect ratio overlays ranging from square to super wide, as well as different types of grids and safe zone overlays. If anyone thinks that these could be helpful for them, I'll put a download link in the description. So let's just select the 1.0, in other words, square overlay. The window closes, and immediately I can see the black bars on each side covering my image, showing me the maximum area I'll be able to see should I choose to conform my project into a square aspect ratio. Going back to the Show Custom Overlay submenu, I can now choose to make the bars more or less transparent. The overlays are also global, meaning that even if I switch to a different project, that same overlay will still be visible. Unfortunately, they're always overlaid to fit the current frame, not fill. In other words, if I switch to my square project, we see the overlay scale down, which is unfortunate. Something that I've already put in a request for as well, alongside a request to overlay them with a different blend mode, which would make them better visible when overlaying the same color in the video image, such as a black line over a very dark video. So if I want to add even more overlays to choose from, I can simply repeat the procedure as before. Or if there are several I'd like to add all at the same time, I can go back into the Choose Custom Overlay submenu, and here at the bottom, select Reveal in Finder. After which Final Cut opens the folder in the Finder in which all the overlay images are saved. Now I can simply copy any image I'd like to use as an overlay into the folder. Back in Final Cut, I can see that I now have access to all of the images I just added. Another feature request for me is to have subfolders, since this can quickly get very full. Now I can, for example, select the overlay I put together, which contains all the various aspect ratios that might be relevant to me for reference, from a 1.9:1 all the way to a 9:16 viewing area. Another overlay I put together, for example, for when I'm in a vertical video, is an IGTV overlay, which shows me a worst case scenario when watching vertical videos on Instagram. So if I want to make sure that the most important parts of my video are always visible, even when all of the possible on-screen elements are active, I can use this as a reference. Or even various grids, and so on. Of course, any and all of these are not rendered into the final movie, should I leave them active before exporting. In other words, if you need any of these burnt in, you'll need to import them as regular graphics. So, one of my personal favorites amongst the new features. So, was that helpful? Again, if so, then maybe give me a quick thumbs up, or even hit the subscription button and little bell to help the channel, which allows me to continue to produce these free tutorials, and so you don't miss future ones. For that, a huge thank you in advance, and I hope to see you in the next one, or maybe in one of these videos that YouTube thinks you need to have seen as well. Either way, until then, take care.